on Lifetime's Intimate Portrait.
My wife and kids was almost like my second chance to prove myself as a businesswoman, to prove myself as an actor, to prove my professionalism.
And what do you do in this scenario of yours?
I bring home the bacon.
Well, honey, I have an opportunity to bring home some steak.
Tisha Campbell-Martin is a triple threat talent.
She could sing her behind off.
Beyond being a wonderful actress, has a great comedic imagination.
Brittany and Janet, beware, because Tisha could dance her ass off.
Tisha came from the mean streets of Newark.
I didn't have anything to lose. You can't get any poorer than this.
By the time she was 8, Tisha's talent helped provide for her family.
She was a breadwinner, and that's a big responsibility to have as a child.
At 24, she made Sparks Fly with Martin Lawrence.
I have a feeling about our chemistry.
But then she was blindsided by depression.
And I wanted to commit suicide.
Until life took on new meaning. Now, the story of a trailblazer who helped others and never forgot where she came from. This is Lifetime's Intimate Portrait of Tisha Campbell-Martin. Lifetime's Intimate Portrait, hosted by Meredith Vieira.
It's one thing to be a chaperone at your daughter's prom, but how about getting the chance to throw a prom for your own mother? Tisha Campbell-Martin's mom was too busy raising a family to get through high school, so she waited till her kids were grown and then went ahead and got herself a diploma. Tisha couldn't resist the chance to celebrate a woman who had made her own success possible. And now that Tisha's starring with Damon Wayans on the hit sitcom My Wife and Kids, you can be sure there's a lot more celebrating yet to come. But don't measure Tisha's success by the number of hit shows she's been in. She doesn't. This is her story, her words.
In the spring of 1997, the sweet success of the hit comedy series Martin had soured into a real-life drama for 29-year-old actress Tisha Campbell-Martin.
There was a low period for me at one point. Very, very low.
This particular time was one of the toughest, to see her really struggle, and I saw depression.
It was the beginning of a painful soul searching that resulted in a 3-year absence from the limelight.
She did disappear from the public, but she gave us all a call and was like, I'm going through something right now. I need you guys just to believe in me.
After the Martin show, she was doubting herself and that, thinking that, you know what, people are going to see me as Gina for the rest of my life.
When Tisha wanted to return to acting in 2000, Hollywood was almost ready to give up on her.
I asked my agent to, you know, submit me. They didn't want to see me.
This time, Tisha fought for the role she wanted. The little girl who once lived on Poverty Row wasn't about to move backwards.
We were very, 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 very poor. Very poor.
Mona Shockley was just 16 when she became pregnant. She quit high school and married Clifton Campbell. One day before her 17th birthday, on October 13th, 1968, Mona gave birth to a daughter, Tisha Michelle, in Oklahoma City, Oklahoma.
I thought she was gonna be my little gift, my little doll baby. But she wasn't at all. She was really a sight to reckon with.
It was funny. She had gray eyes, a pointed head, you know. I mean, Tisha, oh my God.
Tisha turned out to be just fine. In 1969, Mona and Clifton Campbell returned to the inner city of Newark, New Jersey, with 1-year-old Tisha. Newark was where the young couple had met as aspiring singers.
We come from a family background of singing. My sister, myself, and a niece sang as a singing group called Shockley Singers. And her father used to sing in a doo-wop group on a corner, so there was always music around.
Music played an important role in young Tisha's life.
we get in the circle and start singing, she would sit in the middle and listen to the harmony.
Didn't even encourage that. I guess she was also emulating what we were doing.
Then the next thing I know, I seen her in a big room practice and rehearsal.
I was a very shy kid. The only time I wasn't shy was when I was singing. They started taking me to like schools and the projects where we used to live. They used to hold talent shows in the projects. I used to perform.
Tisha could forget about poverty when she was performing, but the harsh reminder was just outside her front door.
The bricks, that's another term for where I come from. They were like these high rises that were like 12 stories, and they're bricks, all bricks. There was no grass.
By 1974, five-year-old Tisha had three younger brothers, Stanley, Tay, and Jermaine. It got even harder for the Campbells to support their growing family.
I was always like the little mama. You know, if my mom and dad had to work, I was taking care of my little brothers.
In November 1974, the mature six-year-old put her voice to the test at a local talent competition.
She took the microphone and she just started prancing across the stage and making expressions. I said, wow, there's something special about her.
Tisha won the contest, and it gave her an idea.
I saw that it could make us some money. I felt it was my responsibility to help put food on the table, and I felt like I need to help take care of my family.
At seven, Tisha went to her first open casting call in New York for a CBS after-school special.
And I auditioned, and I had to sing. And so after that, they said, can you act? And my parents were sitting in the room like this. She can't act. And so I said, yes. They asked me to do tap. I tapped and tapped my little tail off, and I got it. I got the role.
Tisha began to score roles on children's television programs. In 1976, the PBS children's show, Big Blue Marble, featured Tisha and her family.
My name is Tisha Campbell. I'm 8 years old, and I go to Haywood Avenue School in Orange, New Jersey. My mother works with me with my singing and my acting. Me,
yeah. Tisha's jobs were bringing in extra money, but she was still just a kid.
We were playing in the dark hallways, just running up and down the stairs. But we had fun. We were creative. We found ways to play. We had each other.
All the kids in the neighborhood always wanted to be around us because we always had fun, always had adventure. We call them adventures. Let's go on an adventure, Dad.
My dad was amazing with children. My dad has this gift of just knowing how to pull the best out of kids. And they really look up to him.
We were close. We were like the Brady Bunch, honestly.
The Campbells were a devoted family. But they were a family in constant search of employment and cheap housing.
We moved from city to city to city.
Orange, East Orange.
Newark to East Orange to Orange, back to
Newark, Rahway, Elizabeth, Linden.
So we never had to make new friends after a while.
Tisha knew what being poor was like, but she was also a big dreamer.
I had this book, like it was a photo album, and I would tear things out of magazines and put it into the book. I'm gonna have a house, or I'm gonna have grass. Grass to me, having a garden was a humongous big deal. And a blender, that's what I want. I don't know what to blend, but I'm gonna blend something.